Somebody called in sick. Get over here. Be a good sport. Why is he looking that way? I don't understand. You are a mess. So, Skip Bayless.
Zoom in on the head.
He's wearing TNT gear, the Money Team hat, as well as the Money Team shirt, and it says the best ever, TBE.
There you go. It looks nice on you, man. You know what I love about it more than anything?
Uh-huh.
The shirt is actually in Cowboys colors.
The hat.
And the beautiful.
The hat looks like an engineer's hat.
Hey, listen, you bought this on yourself. Skip Bayless will be wearing this for 2 hours. 2 hours today.
Wait, time out. Yes. Is that the deal?
Yes, it is.
He's wearing
Just like I wore a Dallas Cowboys jersey and hat for 2 hours.
Whoa.
He's keeping that on for 2 hours.
You're keeping it? Okay. I didn't know.
Nothing to say. This show belongs from start to finish to my partner, Stephen A. Smith, who thinks he was victorious on Saturday night. The stage is yours.
All right. What happened, my friend?
Manny got schooled.
Okay.
That's what happened. Listen. Was it the most exciting fight in the world? No, it was not. We understand that. There's a lot of people that have been complaining about it. They didn't see a knockout like I predicted. I thought Floyd was going to take him out in the 11th round. It did not happen. You thought Floyd was going to get taken out in the 7th round. It did not happen. Freddie Roach, who, by the way, now owes me a pair of Tom Ford shoes.
Wait, time out.
Okay?
And we looked them up. The shoes that you wanted specifically are $2,000.
That's right. And I want my shoes.
Okay.
I want my shoes, and I expect Freddie Roach to pay up, okay? In reality, in all seriousness, here's what it comes down to, y'all. When you can't hit somebody, it demoralizes you. Manny Pacquiao actually looked like he quit. He looked so frustrated, so demoralized, because he got so schooled. He trapped Floyd Mayweather against the ropes. 1 minute, Floyd Mayweather is doing a rope-a-dope. The next minute, he'll grab him, and he holds him, because that's what Floyd would do. He tried to trap him in the corner. Floyd kept escaping. Floyd was sitting there right in front of his face. The next thing you know, he was gone. Manny Pacquiao connected on 19% of his punches. 81% of his punches. This speed demon that y'all were talking about. This dude with the hand so fast. So much faster than Floyd Money Mayweather. So much more skilled than Floyd Money Mayweather. So much more powerful than Floyd Money Mayweather. Was hitting nothing but air. He got essentially embarrassed. Not because it was literal embarrassment from the perspective that Manny Pacquiao, you know what, oh my lord, he just got completely destroyed. No. What happened is, Floyd Mayweather, as cool as the other side of the pillow, a tribute to my man, the great Stuart Scott, sat up there, came into the ring, heard all of this noise, this nonsense, and everything else, and he said, I'm going to fight my fight. I know what I'm doing. I'm the magician in the ring. It went back to what I told you Floyd told me years ago. I can crack any Da Vinci code in that ring. I'm the best. And that's what he did. He cemented the reality that he is the best of the modern day era. He took Pac-Man. He made him look slow. He made him look hesitant. He made him look like he didn't know what he was doing. And ultimately, he snatched Manny Pacquiao's heart right out of his chest, because Manny Pacquiao didn't have anything. He appeared demoralized. He looked depressed after the fight, then comes up with some excuse about how his shoulder was hurting. Just so you know, after the fight, and then Sunday morning when I was on with Hannah Storm on SportsCenter, Floyd Mayweather and I spoke, and he said, excuses about Manny Pacquiao's shoulder. I came into the fight with two bad shoulders, and everyone knows my history of having bad hands. I've got my massage therapist here right now massaging my hands and taking care of me, because both of my hands was messed up, both of my shoulders were messed up, and it didn't stop me. I didn't make any excuses, so why should Manny Pacquiao get away with it? The boy got schooled. Freddie Roach, 7-time trainer of the year, got schooled. Bob Arum, the great Bob Arum, who's in his 80s, who's been around forever, who was the promoter for Mayweather for 10.5 years, who came on my radio show and told me Floyd's feet are not what they used to be. He can't move. He can't do this. He can't do that. None of it mattered. He got schooled too. And to top it all off, Floyd walked away with a $100 million check that night. I ain't even counting the other $100 million
coming. That's coming in.
All right. I'm talking about the $100 million check that he got Saturday night. He took their money. He took their reputation. He took their bravado. He took their heart. He took everything from them and reduced them to nothing more than an excuse to try and get a rematch with them so they could finally get paid themselves. Floyd Money Mayweather.
This one.
Took it out. Took them out. All of them together. And last but not least, he saved the best for last when he said, yeah. Who's that guy on the show?
He knows your name.
But he said, who's that other guy on the show with Stephen A. Smith? Mm-hmm. Why did he say that? Because he was pointing the finger at you with all of your hyperbole and everything like that. Who's wearing the hat? It is you.
You, my friend.
You, my friend. I will respect you because you honored the bet and you came out and wore what you wore. But in the end, the blasphemy that you spoke, you played the role in doing this to Manny Pacquiao, too.
What?
Then you got what you deserve. The floor is yours.
Uh-huh. I can't.
Have you said enough? Because I've heard enough. Are you done?
I'm done, Skip. Go ahead, man.
He's about to explode. Let me scoot over.
Hold on. I got my tea.
I don't care if I stand up for just a second.
Can you keep me on camera standing, please?
I have worn this garbage long enough. This is it. Done with you.
What?
I have worn this garbage long enough.
You're not going to honor the bet?
This is coming off.
What are you doing?
TBE, the biggest ego ever. That's all this stands for. TBE, the biggest. Where's the camera? Right there, you got it. Right there, right in the camera. Okay. I got to fix my hair. I got to fix me. Now, it's my turn to talk on this show because I got a whole lot to say and you got a whole lot to listen to. You know what, my friend Stephen A. Smith, and I do love you like a brother. Well, sometimes it's difficult.
Yeah, I know. Siblings.
If Floyd Mayweather Jr. had dominated and punished Manny Pacquiao the way you thought he would, if this fight had been stopped in the 11th round the way you called that it would be because Manny just couldn't continue because he was too hurt, you know what? I would wear that blasphemous t-shirt, TBE, and that silly engineer's hat for 2 hours of this show. But that did not happen on Saturday night. Here's the truth of what happened on Saturday night. Manny Pacquiao won that fight. Manny Pacquiao definitely thought he had won the fight because he said so right after the fight, as matter-of-factly and from the heart as he could, I won the fight. Manny Pacquiao went so far as to say the bottom line was, he didn't do nothing. That's my bottom line to the whole fight. Floyd Mayweather didn't do nothing. Evander Holyfield said right after the fight, the former champion we had on this show, what did he say? Manny Pacquiao won this fight fair and square. And I don't even want to talk about the shoulder issue, the shoulder injury. I don't care. Regardless of whether his shoulder was hurt or not, Manny Pacquiao won this fight. As I detailed on Twitter from start to finish, I'm not doing sour grapes. I'm not doing sore loser here. I'm not speaking from the heart. I am speaking from the head with which I scored the fight from round to round. I had it 115-113, Manny Pacquiao. I had Pacquiao winning 7 rounds to Mayweather's 5 rounds. I had Pacquiao winning 2, 3, especially 4 and 6, 10 and 12, which obviously Floyd just conceded 12 because Floyd thought the fight was over. I had Floyd Mayweather winning 1 because Manning came out tentative, 5, 7. I gave Floyd 9, and I don't even think he deserves to win 9, but I gave it to him. And round 11, I thought Floyd won round 11. This thing's driving me crazy,
I'm
done with the shirt, with the hat, and with my IFB for this segment. Okay. All that I saw that Floyd Mayweather did was he mostly ran and he danced and he rope-a-doped after he blasted the great Muhammad Ali in your all-access piece, saying that he was over-glorified for rope-a-doping George Foreman. That's all I saw that he did. He played rope-a-dope. Manny Pacquiao landed more shots, did more damage in rounds 4 and 6 than Mayweather did in the entire fight to Manny Pacquiao. When the fight was over, I thought Pacquiao was ready to go for a jog. He had a little mark up here, but he was mostly unmarked. Most of the damage in the fight was done by Pacquiao to Mayweather, especially in round 4 and 6. And the reason I picked 7, the Pacquiao team told me a month ago they were convinced they could take out Floyd Mayweather within 4 rounds. Obviously, Manny went for the quote-unquote kill in the 4th round. I thought he had Floyd in trouble. I thought he let him off the hook and off the ropes too quickly. Floyd was getting...